recap last time. Tommy did. Okay.
Oh, was it? Oh.
Cool. And either of you two could do it, which is great because John is, I don't think he's read it recently. So since we're now on air, we are live back in the Moat House, adjacent to the Temple of Elemental Evil, which we'll cover once the expert rules come out. Levels 6 to 10.
We're still just level 2, right?
Yeah.
I need fate points. For some reason, the way I play the game, I only get persona points. I'm not sure why that is.
Oh, what a tragedy.
I'm not complaining. I'm just observing. There is a...
Working towards your belief is usually a pretty solid fate generator. Or rather, working towards your goal and playing up your belief are both solid fate generators. Aha! Oh,
you know what, actually...
has arrived.
Actually, I misspoke. I actually get them about equally. I just spend my fate points. I have more persona points, but the totals are about the same.
Yeah.
So.
Well, spend it to level, right? So.
Yeah. I don't think I have any conditions. The end of the actual play talks about Tomer and Comrade Thaspar becoming hungry and thirsty, but since that's not an action, I think we fixed that. Because I don't have it marked on mine. Sheet.
Alright.
Looks like I don't have any wine in my wineskin, so I suspect that's how I fixed it. Because that's not an action, right? We just do it?
Yeah. You just have to do it during a moment of...
Yeah. So, anyways, if it's between Orin and Thaspar for the recap, my vote is Orin.
Orin.
Orin has a condition, and Thaspar does not.
Alright, last time on our adventures, it ended with me looking up and going, "Woo!" But that's... my imminent death is getting a little ahead of myself.
Yeah.
We...
Let's not skip to the good parts yet.
It's a preview of what's to come.
Yeah.
We did start off our last adventure with our camp phase. Thomer went about cooking us up a hearty meal. And it was quite delicious. A hearty stew for our traveling companions. I set about trying to mend my grisly stab wound from the battle prior with the bandits.
Yeah.
With very little success. Basically, I had to do first aid via red hot dagger.
Yeah. Like you do.
Mm-hmm. Suffice it to say, my writing days might be numbered.
Yeah, your lot as a llama rider is unlikely now.
Outlook is grim for llama riding. We did, however, one of the points of significant note is we sent Thaspar's brother, James, back to town. Or rather, we escorted him back to town. We convinced him that this was far too dangerous. Maybe he should come back another time when he is more trained, but not today.
Less concussed. Yeah.
Less concussed, yeah. At first you almost send it back with a concussion, like, go that away, while he was walking all, like, bumping into shit.
So it was pretty hilarious. Maybe we'll wallow him back.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty hilarious that you, like, sent him away with, like, three conditions and just been like, walk through the woods, you're all good.
You're fine.
And then Thaspar at the last moment realized that, yeah, you should probably escort him and got him as far as the city town gates and made sure that he got home safe.
After that, we did some interrogation of our good friend Delmar the Bandit. We beat him down in a conflict with a minor compromise, which was to set him free. Delmar told us that there was some loot to be had and how to get it.
Mm-hmm.
Once we got that juicy bit of information, we let him go, and As he is running off into the dark woods, we heard wolves howling in the distance.
Yep.
Ha ha.
Tomer, I believe, howled back and.
Oh yeah.
To his brothers, yeah. But the rest of you decided that wolves closing in might not be fun times, so you moved on.
Mm-hmm. I tried to pray to Paylor for some guidance as we returned to the moat house, but I quickly was reminded how far my god was and how isolated I was within the dark depths of the moat house. So yeah. I became concerned for our well-being.
Yeah, I think you realized that you were much more evil god adjacent than you were close to your god. That this particular region was much closer to the evil realms, and that the other gods, perhaps Loth and Yugamari and whatever other nefarious gods might have heard your prayers as well.
Yep, yep. But on our way in, I took a moment to pray for Mara's body, the other bandit, as we found her slain shortly inside the moat house. Just to make sure she wouldn't rise to become our enemy yet again.
Right. We found her. You found some other bits.
She was too fresh to turn into torches, so we
found some other
put her to rest.
Pieces of people. Someone else's leg was there, but not enough that could be reanimated, per se. Mara was just missing her hand. It had been bitten off, but otherwise was still mostly there.
Never played Bitesies with the gnolls.
Yeah. Yeah, Bitesies is not a fun game. I mean, unless you're a gnoll. Burnsies also not a fun game. No. Bitesies, Clawsies, Hit with Sticksies, those are all...
I prefer to play Tricksies and Hidesies when the gnolls are involved.
Yeah. Well, Hidesies they like too, but their version of it is a little different. I mean,
it's not good, but so far we haven't run into them yet.
Not yet, no.
But after Tomer did a little bit of lockpicking, we managed to find ourselves a chest in the room that they had held secure mm-hmm. prior
there
to
the
There
was battle. A bunch of... since from the battles of yore that everyone, especially Thaspar, has heard about as stories from the last generation of heroes, this moat house was sieged, and so on the outside, a lot of it's crumbling, especially in the upper levels, and like half the wall to this room was collapsed in, and so there's all this rubble, and they... hidden underneath it was where the chest was.
Hmm. And just as we're checking out the loot and deciding to leave it there for now to come back and pick up later, something dark descended upon our group, specifically me. Dusty.
Yeah. 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 Exactly. Or you saw something looming in the shadows, in the rafters above. Cool. What conditions do you have right now, Oren?
I just have afraid.
All right. I think you can get rid of afraid through the prologue. These players who missed last session... No. Player who delivers the prologue can remove hungry, thirsty, angry, afraid, or exhausted in that order. Go ahead and remove afraid, which is quite nice. And then before we start play, let's review everyone's beliefs, instincts, and goals. Make sure those are still current and relevant and update them if they're not. So,
yeah.
So let's start with you just gave us the prologue, let's go ahead and start with Thaspar. And what is your belief right now?
My belief is I need to hold the group together.
Okay. Do you want to stick with that?
I think that's going pretty good.
All right. Tomer, your belief?
I must be a good dog and look after Thaspar's best interests.
Nice. Keeping it?
Yeah.
Okay. And, Oren, your belief?
My friend's health is more important than my own.
That may be put to the test very soon. Awesome. Cool. Thaspar, what's your goal?
My goal is out of date. The one I believe I have right now is I will research the moat house before returning, which is too late. So I kind of want to push on that a little bit because I want to touch base with everyone about... So, Oren, for a while, we had a whole thing about we had a blanket to give to get a...
Six toes.
Get six toes body, and we were supposed to do stuff with that. And I think the blanket's been messed up.
Yep, yes. Crossbow bolt's gone through and torn it all up.
So, I guess the goal I want to have at this point is related to that. Now, mm-hmm. in terms of what's a reasonable thing that we think we're going to get done this session, I'm a little unclear. So we have to fix the blanket, then find six toe. Then do the right. Is that correct?
Yeah.
That fixing doesn't sound like it's going to happen this session.
No, but breaking it down smaller also is a weak goal. Like, I want to fix the blanket is, I want to make one test. So...
Yeah. Well, I want something in between there, right? I mean, because the goal is supposed to be something we could do this session, so...
No, isn't it? Not necessarily.
Goals should be done in a session or two. So,
or two, okay.
Yeah, I don't think not every goal needs to be completed in a single session. So I think we will find Six Toes Body would be kind of an intermediate one, but also we will consecrate Six Toes Body would be fine. And you probably wouldn't do it in one session, but it's probably doable in two.
Okay. I think that's the goal I want to take at this point. I mean, that was kind of originally Oren's, but we can share.
You can totally share.
So I'm gonna. So the goal is, we will. I'm gonna phrase it a little differently though, because religion and Thaspar and blah de blah de blah de blah.
Sure.
We will do right by six toe.
Be more specific about how I know whether you've done right by him.
Okay.
I understand you not wanting to frame his religious. That's cool, but.
We will honor Six Toes' parents' wishes?
Mm-hmm. That's fine. I mean, it's pretty clear what they want. They want their son wrapped up in the blanket and you know, their religious beliefs observed in action, if not in faith.
Yeah, and it's just a weird Thaspar in his head thing about... he wants to do right by his friend, and that means doing what his parents want. And
right, even if he doesn't.
That's religious, and he's not going to argue with him about it.
Sure. Cool. Sounds good. Tomer, what's your goal?
I don't have one right now.
Oh, well, let's get you one. So you're in the moat house with your master, Thaspar.
Yeah, I want my long-term goal is to help my master return to his pack and raise his status. And so, but then, like, how can I, like, what's the next step to helping with that?
Yeah. Well, you saw firsthand.
Something that's actionable.
Yeah, I mean, you saw firsthand how his father totally was how the leader of his pack, he was a complete outcast.
Right.
Like, they took him in, but it was incredibly begrudging.
No, you people are all confused. That's the Red Claw clan. This is the Flamebringer clan.
Yeah, well...
or pack, I guess.
So, I mean, I think it's unfortunate that James is gone, because I think finding out, like, what Ignis would need to accept his son is, like, a totally legitimate goal, but it would be very difficult to do right now. Like, you don't have any frame of reference except for Thaspar, who has not been... players having goals aimed at getting information out of other players is... it's fine, but it's difficult.
Right, I know. Okay.
You know, you're sort of forced to only operate in camp... And spend checks and things like
other
that.
Other than that, I want to make our pack. I want to make the Flamebringer pack greater than the Red Claw pack. To strengthen our pack, I want more pack members.
You could certainly try to recruit. I mean, you know, there's other bandits and whatnot in the area.
That would be mine.
Awesome.
To work towards that.
Cool. How do you want to phrase it? I'll recruit more members to the pack?
I want to grow the pack. Find a new member for the pack.
Awesome.
To make it stronger.
I like it. Yeah. Technically speaking, I'm not really sure how we handle NPCs. I mean, we had James in the party for a little while, and that seemed to work out okay. So
James did not make our pack stronger.
No, he didn't. But
yes,
awesome.
He didn't qualify for that.
Yeah. He was in nature too regular. All right, and Oren, your goal?
My goal is to find our way back to Six Toes' body.
Cool. And your instinct?
My instinct is always check for the presence of undead.
Cool. Do you want to keep that?
Yes.
Awesome. Daspar, your instinct?
I still got the if we find lore, study it, which I think sometimes it's super helpful and sometimes it doesn't come up, but I'll keep it for now.
Okay. Sounds good. And Tomer, your instinct?
I always cook when we make camp, and I want to keep it. I cool. like cooking.
Awesome. So, let me pull up the box text again, if there is something in this room.
Can I interject real quick here, though? But
absolutely.
Can we talk a little bit about what's wrong with the blanket? It's probably camp phase to fix, but what's the situation?
Yeah, it's got two holes in it where a crossbow shredded it up. You know, okay. A crossbow bolt went into Oren's backpack, and right. It was saved. He was saved from it impaling him by it shredding the blanket. I mean, it's just got holes in it. They can be patched. You've got cloth. So
let's be clear, guys. I think this is actually an improvement because now the blanket is holy.
Oh, God. That was terrible.
You're sorry.
Fired. Okay. Go to the doghouse.
We do actually have a couple of bolts of this fine linen that I'm carrying around for some reason. And yeah, I have weaver skill, so in theory, like if we're at a camp phase, I could spend some checks to fix that.
I mean, I think you're carrying it around because it's worth money, but also...
Yeah, I think it's the balance of it was the lightest loot, the most valuable kind of thing. But we may have actually talked about using it to fix the blanket. I just wanted to make sure that, you know, if I needed something else to fix the blanket, that I knew that was my goal to get that.
Sure.
But it sounds like my goal right now is just to get some checks and get to a camp without dying. Or need to spend the checks on staying alive.
Awesome. All right, so a reminder of the room. This is a tall vaulted. This is a tall room with a vaulted ceiling. The wall has collapsed on the edge, so you can see beyond just the windows in the room to the outside, which are covered with curtains. You can see. Cracks of light that come through at the top where the stone had crumbled in. The floor itself is black flagstone, which is different than the rest of the whole keep. Obviously, this is like the nicest place that this keep originally had. And now it's just littered with like the bandits, various, you know, the bandits all held up in here. So they had their bedrolls and their little campfires just scattered throughout. There is a heavy black bearskin rug in the center, but it's been burnt and charred and worn, and people have wiped their muddy boots and probably their asses on it. So it's seen better days.
So we can't make a torch out of it.
You could prepare. You could probably use it as materials, but it's not. Okay. It is not a torch itself. Okay. This room provide because the windows are small and the cracks of light are, and the cracks of in the ceiling don't provide a lot of light. There's dim light in this room by default, at least during the day, which it is right now.
Well, I'm carrying a torch. How many turns we've had it lit is a
you've had question. two turns that have passed. Let me check. Two turns that have passed since the camp phase, but I think at least one of those. Turn one was picking
the
lock.
We were outside at that point, yeah.
Turn two was labor. Yeah, so two turns have passed inside. Since this camp phase. One to One to pick the lock and one to do labor.
Yeah, your write-up says at the start of the adventure phase. We got to the moat house after dark, and so I lit a torch.
Yeah.
So,
I have a question.
Two turns.
Oh, you guys arrived after dark. Whoops, I got that wrong.
Oh, well, I'm just reading your...
Yeah, no, I'm just...
thing, so, but that sounds okay. Right. So now, and that's why I'm two turns into this torch, because we were outside for a while, but we were outside at night.
Yeah.
Oh, but you're talking about the dim light, yeah.
Yeah, there's no dim light, sorry. There would be.
The torch is good light for me and somebody else and dim light for the other, right?
Well, it would be, except for torch's last two turns, so... That's when it's when Dasper's torch begins to burn down that Orin sees the shadow shift above and realizes that there's motion in the rafters.
Does it actually take a turn to light a new torch from the guttering remains of the last torch?
No. I mean, it oops, I got to plug in my laptop. One second.
I'll be right back. I'll take this. I've been waiting to go away. Hold on.
The mass exodus.
I mean, it is the game's name, after all.
It only takes a turn if there's a test involved. Like, there might be a survivalist test to light a torch under difficult circumstances, but in this case, there's no difficulty with that.
So I have more torches in my backpack, so I'm just going to go ahead and light another torch. You know, essentially, when we get to the point where the first one's about to go out, I will light another one.
Okay. So
I have a fresh torch at the start of turn three, basically.
Awesome. Sounds good. So you've just lit a torch, and Orin, it's
I have a question. Shoot.
When do
I become level two?
When you return to town after having spent 3 fate and 3 persona.
Oh, I've spent 4 and 7.
Cool. Then when you return to town.
Okay.
At the start of town phase.
Okay. Thank you.
All right.
Tomer can't wait.
Orin, as Thassbar relights the torch and it casts a reddish hue across the room, that's when you realize something has scuttled just outside of your range, just outside of your vision. But you can see the shadows bending and twisting strangely above you. You hear a rustling and little motes of dust pour down as something moves and a bit of dust from the rafters shakes off. And in the torchlight, you can see these motes of dust sparkling.
I don't really like the verb scuttle. Can we use, like, you know, caper or frolic instead?
Skitter?
No, I don't like skitter. Prance? Prance is a good one.
Fast bar.
How about stalk?
So we're in the room with a door?
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember. Did you guys close the door behind you?
I don't think so.
It seemed like something bad happened to the door on our way through. Maybe that was the first pass through. The first time through, there was some attacking.
There was. It had been repaired since then. And Tomer picked a lock on it. So you guys got in without... without having to destroy anything.
And the spider that we chased off was in the tower, not in this moat house proper.
Right.
Tomer's going to draw his sword and back away towards the door.
Okay.
Saying,
Thassbar, I think we've outstayed our welcome here.
I
think it's a groove.
So we should move on then, I guess, yeah? So, Sean, how much of the moat house proper have we explored at this point? Because we went down where we found the snake,
mm-hmm.
and that's kind of on the map, I think. I wasn't there for part of that, but I think I got that relayed to me. And then
we kind of went through the south wing, the southeast. I mean, if it's a square. You kind of went through the southeast wing where the snake was, the northeast where you are right now. The southwest is the open area.
The tower, where we found the book and fought the spider and all.
Yeah. It's really only the northwest section that you raced through last time and haven't explored. So there's a good quarter of the moat house. There's a good, you know, significant section of the moat house that you guys haven't.
So it's mostly the northwest of the moat house we need. Yeah. And then...
You haven't explored.
From the dealing with... Getting back to Six-Toe situation, the problem is... We went through part of the northwest, but that's where we did that whole run away from the ghouls and then run away from the ghouls some more and then get into the caverns and run away from the ghouls some more and then run into the gnolls. So we know that his body is to the northwest somewhere, but we can't retrace that route because there were a bajillion ghouls.
Yep.
So we need to find it. I mean,
you can't fast track it. You're going to have to re-explore and dig around.
Well, but I mean, even more than that, there was some sort of catastrophic, like we went down, we ran through a crypt that we knew there were dozens of ghouls. And then I think there was even a cave-in, wasn't there?
No, there was just,
there was we cannot go back the way we came.
There was this area, this has become impassable. Yeah.
Right, and so we need to find a new way down to his body. Is essentially what we're thinking.
Yeah. I mean,
or we're thinking maybe explore more cautiously to the northwest.
Well, that was also remember that's in the level below the northwest. I'm only speaking of the ground level, the dungeon level. There's a lot. there's a whole bunch. But the dungeon level, in terms of Six Toes. Is that you couldn't pass through that section from the area from the way you came down through to the area you came out? Meaning, passing through that would mean going through countless amount of ghouls that would rip your faces off. Doesn't mean you can't go to the edges of either of those from either of the sides. Impassable. It just means an impassable even doesn't even actually mean it's completely impassable. It just means it would be suicidal to do it. But you could
try. I'm just trying to figure out with, you know, the what map notes I have, where the best place to try to start getting back to
You could try and work your way back from either side.
First, we have to get out of this room.
Yep. Well, right, but I'm just figuring out whether we're going to go out to the northwest or the south, and it sounds like
there's only one set of stairs down. I mean, you guys have to first get down.
Damn.
You guys are on the you're not in the dungeon right now. You're in the moat house above. He's down below in the dungeon.
Yeah.
Okay. Get to the stairs.
Right. Oh, and the stairs are to the northwest, right? Though.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. So that's the answer then. All right. So we want to go to the northwest.
So Tomraz is back to the Tomraz is back to the door with his sword out,
and he's growling low growl.
All right. So.
You hear the sounds of something, some screeching noise, not screeching, some noise of chittering noise above you of teeth, tiny incisors clacking together.
All right, so let's kind of get our backs to the wall and head out to that corridor off to the northwest.
Cool.
And I'll kind of brandish the torch as high as I can.
Awesome. As you do, you see something kind of flee from the light. You see, you catch the edge of a long, hairy leg that skitters up out of the light, and you see more dust kind of float about as boards above you creak from the weight. Thaspar, you open the. Who's opening the door?
It is open. We didn't shut it, did we?
Oh, you didn't shut it. Okay. Yeah. Sorry. Okay. So awesome. Okay. So your back's against the door, Tomer. You gonna stand and wait till your friends get out, or are you getting out of this room?
I'm backing out of this room.
Okay, cool.
I'll back out, but make sure Thaspar goes first.
All right.
So I follow.
Sure. I mean, yeah. So we go kind of because I mean. I've got the torch, right? So there's a bit that I go last, but you go, you know, 6 inches in front of me. You know what I mean?
So it's cool. Yeah. So you guys are going together. So Oren, you're the last one inching out. When you see the thing flying at you from the rafters, you hear a hiss, and as soon as it's seen that that the numbers are in its favor, this thing comes descending down upon you.
Shut the door!
Yeah, I'm going to try and slam the door in its face.
Nice. So you try to leap out and slam the door before it can get to you?
Yep.
Cool. It's just a health test.
All right. I got 4 dice for that.
Cool. Someone's going to be surprised when they open that door.
Yeah. It's going to be a versus against its nature.
I'm going to take a point. I'm going to get a check for using my brave trait, say, since I'm going out last.
Okay, cool. So it'll get 2 dice. Or are you losing a die?
I'm losing a die.
Okay, sounds good.
I'm using my running nature.
Running nature won't help slam the... I mean...
No, I know. I'm just saying.
I know. I mean, it's totally fair. Like, if you want to help, I think that's fire, but you would have to...
I know.
...help by either being on the lookout, like, there
I
it
am
is,
on the lookout.
Or help by, you know, getting behind the door and helping slam it or shoving the thing out or shoving its clawed...
Right.
Claws, you know, back through the door before it can pry itself through. So, yeah, does anybody want to help Oren?
With a nature check?
Is that, this would be, well, tell me what you'd do. This is a health test, so virtually any kind of physical action that would help shut this door on this giant spider before it descends upon you.
Yeah, can I, can I do like a last split second lunge and just sort of shove my torch in the spider's face and then yank it back out as he slams the door, trying to drive the spider back?
Yeah.
You know, so it's absolutely. Like a split second. I pull the torch in just as he closes it.
Sure.
All right, I will do that.
And
I'm just on the lookout for other threats and what's behind us.
Okay. In this case, there aren't any. So that is.
It could get worse.
It's a good thought.
Could get worse, yeah. Well, no, actually, there are other threats. Now that I think about it, yeah. Go ahead and give Oren that helping die from Scout.
Alrighty. Let's see how the dice fall. Not favorably.
I had 5 dice and I got 4 successes because. You know, the world hates you guys.
Well, it does. I only had 2 successes.
Because that's what Sean does.
Yeah, I roll really well. That's how I GM. That's my GMing skill, is rolling dice really well.
Cheaty dice.
Yeah.
I like that you have the map of the world behind you.
I know. It feels like he's some sort of evil overlord.
I keep feeling like we should have the Indiana Jones travel lines, you know? As we head off to Calcutta or whatever.
Yeah. I'd be great for a Fate game or Spirit of the Century.
Nice.
Okay.
So, yeah, this would be perfect for a Spirit of the Century. It's even kind of parchment decolored. I love it. When you slam the door, 2 of its legs get through, and it's scratching at you, And it starts with vice-like strength. You can see the legs like pressing the door open, where it's like prying the 2 legs are prying the door away from the wall. And you're just like giving it all your might. This thing has tremendous strength. And that's part. It's when you gouge it. Like as it starts to come out, and you can sort of like see its man, you can see its body start to try and push out. Uh-huh. You shove the torch in its face. It pushes it back, and it slips and loses its grip. And you shove it all the way in, but it takes your torch with you. And the door slams shut, and boom, you're in total darkness.
Okay.
As your torch has disappeared on the other side, and you can hear the thing scuttling and crawling and scratching at the door, and it sounds like a dagger sticks in the door and then is dragging down it as its claws tear at the door, and Oren, you're just like fiercely holding onto it, trying to keep it from pushing it open. So it's scuttling
like?
And making noise.
It was a spider.
From the couple legs and teeth you saw, yeah, it looked like it was a big a big spider.
Have I seen spiders this size before? Is this like the one we saw before? Is this worse?
This was... Tomer was not around at this point, but this is, in fact, the same spider you guys saw before.
I was going to ask the same question, basically.
It's taken up new inhabitants since nothing lives here anymore.
I heard tales of the spider. I didn't see it myself, but...
Yeah.
It's got our chest. We'll have to go back and deal with it eventually, but it can have my torch. I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
I'm going to go ahead and try and reinforce the door so it doesn't get out.
Right. Push. What are you going to do to reinforce the door?
What's around me? Is there any like sort of large rocks or rubble that I can just wedge against the door?
So it's a good question. You guys are in the main Great Hall. This was once a great audience chamber, as shown by the tattered banners and tapestries on the wall. Destroyed furniture and heaps of rotting cloth are thrown into the corners. Once richly appointed, it has been thoroughly searched, sacked, and despoiled. Leaves and dirt cover the floor, and cobwebs hang from the walls and ceiling above. Or at least that's what you remember before it was totally dark in here. You do remember there was all kinds of old furniture and whatnot that used to be splendid, but at this point you can't see any of it. You kind of know it's vaguely like that away, you know. If you walk away, this thing's going to push through the door. You're also sure of that.
Well, I can light a torch that you guys can then see what door blocking we can do. If you guys hold the door for a second, I'll go ahead and light another torch. How about that?
Sounds good to me.
Do you guys have anything else you want to do, Thomas?
I was going to say that I would have had to give you one of my torch because I didn't have another slot. So can you take one of my torches?
Sure.
This retconning.
Tomer's been holding it for you, a sword in one hand and an unlit torch in the other hand.
He's got it in his mouth.
I'll take Tomer's torch, and then I still have the two torches in my bag.
I'm just saying, before I would have had to do it before we left.
How many torches are in a batch? I don't think I was at a full batch of torches.
Four.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I had three torches when we started this session, so I could have been carrying four in the same slot.
Okay.
So
I'm gonna hold the door now.
So all I right, had
yeah,
four.
So is Tomer
lost one? I just lost another one. So I've got two in my bag, and I'm lighting another one now. Sound good?
Sounds good. So Tomer is helping Oren keep the door propped shut.
I'm gonna try and lock it.
I can see
anything.
You can totally do that as soon as you can see. Absolutely. Right now you're like, yeah. All right. So Thaspar, do you have a
tinderbox?
Tinderbox?
It's in my pouch. My belt pouch.
Cool.
I am the Flamebringer.
Awesome. So
supposed to be my spell, but for now I'll settle for a tinderbox.
So yeah, someday you'll get Elder Starts or something. So remember, Tomer, when you said you were looking to see if
the light went out, but I use all my senses. I smell and hear.
Yeah. So you smell a wet moldy fur, wet dog musk.
Oh.
And you hear kind of a sniggering. And it's sort of echoing. You can't tell exactly where it's coming from.
Okay.
I think it's some Hanna-Barbera comic where there was some character that had like a snigger.
Yes,
that was was very iconic. I wish I could remember what it was now. But yeah, you hear this sniggering, and it just sort of echoes around. It's pretty faint, but you're aware of that. Okay.
Does it seem like gnolls to you, Tomer?
What does my wolfwise tell me?
Oh, yeah. Because totally
he was around when we fought the gnolls.
It's totally a gnoll cackle. Absolutely.
Okay.
It's totally a gnoll cackle. You are absolutely being laughed at by gnolls right now. Like, Tomer, you know this for sure. Everyone else wouldn't know, but you have wolfwise. Or they're laughing at something. Maybe it's far enough off. It could be gnolls laugh all the time because they're always doing heinously awful things to each other. So maybe they're not laughing at you, but
Muttley sniggered.
Yes. Muttley? That's it. Exactly. It's a total Muttley. It's exactly the Muttley sound.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay. Thus far, you rifle through your things and are able to light a torch, no problem. And Orin, the door occasionally slams open and a tiny bit of torchlight comes through, and then you like slam it shut again. And it's like in one of those moments where a tiny bit of light comes through, that's where you're able to see your tinderbox light it and get your torch lit back up again.
Excellent.
Yeah, so it's pounding away at it. Tomer?
What do I need to do to lock the door? I have lockpicks.
Tell me what you do. Lead in the fiction.
Lead in the fiction.
Yeah, lead by describing your actions.
Yes.
Sure.
Say hello to Karen.
John says hi.
I have thieves' tools. I know how to lock a door. I'm going to take my thieves' tools out of my backpack and fiddle with the lock to get to reverse lockpick it.
So it wasn't
hold the door solid so that it keep it stable so I can move the tumblers.
So it wasn't that hard to pick this lock, but it's really hard to pick or unpick a lock when it's moving. Because first off, you're like, your tools are really tiny. But second off, you can't actually latch it until the door is really closed. If it keeps like rattling back and forth, like the bolt won't move.
Hold the door.
Could I?
Orin, do you have anything? Do you have anything stronger to hold the door with?
I could try spikes. I don't really have spikes, but I could possibly like use my. Is there like a doorknob? Of some sort.
Sure. Yeah. There's like a lever you push down. So once it's unlocked, you can push down the little lever to lift up the latch.
Okay.
It's not a knob per se, but it's a.
I'm gonna try and like use my warhammer as a wedge underneath that to try and help keep it closed.
Cool.
While awesome. leaning into the door.
Awesome. Daspar, did you say you wanted to also throw a wizard's aegis up against this thing?
I was debating it if I could use it basically as like a plane of force to kind of just hold the door, you know,
yeah,
with the wizard's aegis for a second so he could lock it.
Yeah, if you want to.
I will totally do that.
Sweet.
Okay.
So that's one of my two wizard aegises.
Is this my criminal?
Nice. So a butt of solid force. Daspar's incantation.
I'll just slam it up to wherever it seems like the spider is impacting on the other side. I'll try to kind of brace it there, but out of the way of the lock.
Nice. And then it finally the latch finally closes again, not locked but latched, and you get your warhammer wedged in there. And then Tomer can lock it. You realize you could probably also leave it not locked, and just leave your warhammer wedged in there if you want.
Nope.
I mean, it can't operate the mechanism very well. No. Okay. Cool.
So Tomer, am I getting help from two other people? Do I roll criminal?
You're just picking the lock. You've picked this one before. Mm-hmm. It's a little bumpy and a little shaky, but you turn the tumbler, and and the lock latches back into place.
Oof.
Go back for those.
I will snigger.
Actually, though.
You'll snigger. Nice. it sounds oddly familiar. So the thing scrambles and it bats at the door, but like once it can tell that the door is no longer giving any, like the door is pretty solid, it's a heavy door, it stops, you know, eventually. Like it keeps battering for a little while, but it dies down.
Good boy, Tomer.
Indeed.
Cool. So, I just described the Great Hall. Above you, you can see, like, where the battlements that used to be accessible, that used to be able to walk on, have now collapsed from siege attacks many ages ago.
So now that we have some light, can we tell any place where gnolls might be hanging out or were hanging out recently? Or
I'd like to track the source of the sniggering.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, I mean, you know, there's kind of only three directions, right? There's to your right, which is the path that leads to the stairs. To your left, you're standing like at the corner of a square. You can go to, you know, the corner that's adjacent to the left, the corner adjacent to the right, or the opposite corner. The opposite corner is the entrance to the keep that leads outside. The left corner is a passageway that goes down to where you guys fought the snake, and the right corner is where you know the stairs. Somewhere in there, like there's a hallway, and there's several doors, and through one of those doors, you guys ran through, and there were some stairs. But Tomer, you're trying to locate the source by listening for it.
Yeah.
Because it's echoing in this chamber a little bit.
Depending upon how strong the smell is, I will go where the smell is stronger.
Yeah.
Strongest. I won't hurry ahead. I'll go ahead of Thaspar. You know, if it's not the way that I'll look back at him. So you know, if it's not the way that we want to go downstairs, you know, whether I'll keep looking back to him for whether we should continue. If it's in the direction we want to go, then I'll just keep going.
Cool. Awesome. Why don't you, as you're listening and you're smelling and you're using your wolf senses.
Right. I'm wolf-wise.
Yeah. Go ahead and give me a scout roll.
So, okay. I've got some partial maps of the area, and I'm also mode house-wise, so can I help him kind of point out where I think... Like, I know where the gnolls came from originally, and so I'm looking for areas that, you know, oh, well, maybe this door would be the right thing, or maybe that passageway heads off in the proper direction. Using the map I have, my cartography skill, and my mode house-wise knowledge, I will help him out with his scouting.
Okay. Yeah, I'll take that. Go ahead and give him a helping die.
Your die is yellow. And so you have to spend a fate point to use a wise... Can you remind me?
No, there's four ways you can use wise. If you're helping somebody, for you in your case,
like
if you
wise, how does that factor in?
Yeah, after your roll, you could spend a fate die to reroll a fate point to reroll a single failed die, or you could spend a persona point to reroll all failed dice if your wise applies.
Okay.
And in this case, your wise applies.
All right, I'm gonna keep rolling. I'm gonna roll. Here we go.
Cool.
Two sixes.
All right, hold on. I should roll theirs.
And one of them was Thaspar's.
Nice. Thaspar helped. Let's see. Let me make sure the gnolls are acting in their... Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's one of their nature descriptors. Okay. I have four successes.
All right. Well, I could spend a persona point to reroll two of my sixes.
You could spend a fate point to reroll your two sixes.
Okay. I could have used my persona to add a wise.
No, you could do that too. So you could roll. You could spend a point of persona to reroll all your failed dice as part of your wise, or you could spend a point of fate to explode those two sixes, or you could do both.
I'll do both.
Cool. Right now you're in a versus test against a gnoll that
So I reroll two, and I.
Well, just do one at a time.
Okay.
And reroll, exploit your two sixes. See what that takes. Where that takes you.
One more success.
Okay. So they're still beating you.
Yeah. And what is? And that was for.
That was exploiting. Spending a fate and exploiting those two sixes.
4 and 5, and what else can I do with my persona, the persona?
So now, any dice that failed, you can reroll.
Does that include the ones I'd rerolled? that I exploded?
That's a good question. I don't know, but I will say sure. Let me look that up. One second, actually. We'll figure it out. It's been a little while. Wise effects 20. No, I don't think that's it. Wise, oh, maybe 21 seems pretty early on. Using wise is. You may not reroll a die that's already been rerolled. If you roll a 6, spend a fate, reroll. You may not use deeper understanding to reroll that failure. Okay, so no. It would not. It calls out that it only is the dice you originally rolled.
And is it 4 5s or 6s in this game?
Yes.
I now have 5 successes.
Huzzah! Okay. So, here's the thing. You start moving to the west, towards the way that you know. Towards the way that you know the stairs down are. And it's hard to pinpoint the noise at first because, again, this chamber is pretty echoey. But as you're getting closer, you hear just one. You hear just one of these, like sniggering, clearly at you now. Like now, you're sure that's at you. And it's coming from inside. It's coming from down the stairs, it's coming from further in. You can't actually see where it's coming from, but as you get a little closer, you smell that although there's one voice, you can start to pick up really, really faint murmurs, and you pick up mostly you smell with your keen senses, multiple different musks.
Okay.
That there are a couple, although only one is sort of goading you on, there are a couple waiting around the corner from you. And let me look at the map really quick to get you more specific details.
Master, multiple gnolls ahead.
Right. Just make real sure they're not ogres, or that there's not an ogre amongst them.
I don't hear any ogres.
You don't know ogre smell. You know gnoll smell. There are multiple gnolls there.
Well, we encountered the ogre before on the way out.
Yeah. I'm just saying that Tomer's nose is not like universally potent. It's right, okay. Good at making out dog type, wolf type smells.
I got you. Okay.
So
the ogre, that's who we're looking for.
Yeah, so no ogre smells that he recognizes, but so it's not actually where you think the stairs are. It's straight ahead all the way down at the end of the hallway. There's a door, and the door is cracked open ajar just a tiny bit. Like you can barely kind of, with your torchlight, you can barely see inside. But you're certain that there are several gnolls in there, Tomer. You don't know exactly how many, but it's definitely more than
one. Okay.
And, So
what was the status? We left the gnolls. How did our relationship end? They weren't working for us. That was the other game, right?
No, they liked your plan for a little while, and then they got bored with it.
Oh, okay.
You know, there's...
I have to remember which game is which. I'm sorry.
Yeah, there's sort of implicitly no let-it-ride rules in this game, so, like, what works once... Because you didn't really give them anything. You just said, you can go kill humans up there. But you didn't, like, pay them or make any deals with them or anything like that. So they went and had fun times... chewing on bandits, but it didn't earn you any particular specific privileges. And in fact, they laughed at you while you were fighting Lumbash. instead of joining in the fray, because they thought it was hilarious that Lumbash was getting knocked down the steps. So they were so busy laughing that you guys just ran past them.
Yeah, I've got this little bit of a relationship with Tuft and then this other Noel that I kicked in the balls and argued with and played Burnsies. And actually, the Burnsies I think was Orin. But
right. So if you're not caught off guard where they're just going to beat you for the sake of beating you, you could probably negotiate with them. And in this case, you are not caught off guard. You know, you kind of know what's in there. Or you could try to avoid them altogether, hope they don't chase you down. The hallway has the hallway has a door at the very end that's ajar, a door on the right, and a door and two doors on the left that are both closed. All the others are closed, and those you have not explored.
So there's a door at the end, and this is we're facing west in the hallway. Yeah. Is that correct?
Yeah, you're facing west exactly.
Okay, so there's a door at the west end that's open, and we don't know where that goes.
Correct. Yeah, you've never been in there.
There's basically a door to the north and south midway down the hallway that we don't know where they go.
Two doors to the south. But
two doors to the south. Okay, sorry. Yeah,
no problem.
And where are the stairs in relation to this? Do we have any idea?
Where do we want
to... You're pretty sure the stairs are... you remember them going through the door in the north. In fact, I'll say, yeah, it was the door.
Wait. So there's a door at the west end. Is that the door to the north you're talking about?
Nope, there was a door. Remember, down this hallway, there's a door at the west end, a door to the north, and two to the south. There's a...
Okay, there's a third door, okay. So there's a door at the west end, which is open. There's one door to the south, to the north, which is closed.
Yeah, and two doors to the south.
Yep. So the door to the north, I think, leads to the stairs.
Yeah, and all of these are down this hallway that's to the west. Like, none of these... Right. These doors are all clustered right next to each other.
Right, okay.
That's
how,
you know, D&D dungeons are built.
I don't trust these gnolls. I think I don't think we can recruit them to our cause, to our pack.
Yeah, well, I don't know that we want to mess with the gnolls, especially.
So I advise sneaking by them.
So is it possible that the gnolls are coming, the sound and smell of the gnolls is coming through that open door at the west end?
Tom is sure of it.
Okay. Yeah, so, if we can just quietly go open that door to the north, that's what, like, there's these doors to the south, but we're not, stay on target. We don't need to explore the moat house right now. We need to get down to six toes. We need to get to the stairs.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm saying we want to quietly open that door to the north without, like, tipping off. So we don't think the gnolls are sniggering at us. They're just sniggering because they're gnolls and they're awake.
It's hard to tell, yeah. It's a pretty good assessment that's generally what gnolls are doing. I mean, if they're not sniggering at you, they're probably laughing at torturing one of each other. Like,
right. But we don't think they're actually watching us right now. We're just, Tomer realized that they were there.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, they've been laughing for a while now, and we've been pretty far away, so probably not.
So okay, yeah, so great. If Tomer wanted to, he could, you know, sneak up to the door, try to listen in and hear what they were saying.
If you really
only
want
to, Master tells me to. That I am not.
I've had enough Burnsies and Kixies and whatever ogre chases for a while. I'm okay with us just bypassing this all together and sneaking down because they totally won't cut off our retreat later.
Yep. That's what we're doing.
I'm done with Nullsies.
You're done with Nullsies. All right. Okay. So you want to walk past that door? It's open.
Sneak quietly.
And you're trying to sneak past. Okay. So how are you guys going to describe your quiet descent passage through that north door?
I'm actually pretty good at finding paths. So I am definitely, you know, sort of actively, I'm like, we're not in a hurry. We want to be quiet. So mm-hmm. I can take my time to look, bend down real low and look and, you know, make sure that we're not snapping any twigs or, you know, knocking any loose pebbles aside or anything that would make noise. And I will point out to Tomer and Oren, you know, the real, okay, step here kind of thing to cool. try to make our way to the door.
Awesome.
So if we didn't have our torch lit, it would be totally dark.
Yep.
Is that right? So we don't see any light coming from that doorway?
Well, actually, now that you mention it, you do see just the smallest amount of kind of like shadows shifting around. There's not a lot of light coming out because the door is mostly closed. And clearly the room is not like way lit up, otherwise light would just be shining out of it. But there must be some kind of light inside, because every so often you see shadows shifting around that aren't coming from your torch.
Well, I'm going to try and interpose myself so that the torch, if someone sees us go by, that they're not going to see just like a big torch burning.
Nice. You can try and block the light so that.
Yeah,
it's
I'm going to try and block the light, and I can use my cloak if necessary to. Because we need enough light to see, but we don't want to stand out.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you can totally use your cloak as supplies.
As long as it doesn't burn it.
Of course it will.
Exactly.
If you want to, the cloak will go up in flames at the end of this.
Of course. That's what's going to happen, because you're going to roll 4 successes.
Well, no, that's because that's how supplies work, is that they get used up.
Oh.
So you want dice for them, they get used. So we narratively describe it however that happens, but big hole gets burned in it. It's no longer, you know, maybe it's not totally on fire, but...
I don't want to use my cloak as supplies.
You can provide some, you know, you can, while I'm looking for the trail, you can also be kind of keeping an eye on making sure that I hold the torch in such a way that it doesn't...
Right. Okay.
Doesn't
I'm honoring the light, but I'm not using my nice cloak as supplies.
And, you know, you can block a little.
That's fine. You can still hold it out and block. You're just not covering it so much that as to smother it. That's fine. So, cool. So, Dasper, give me a scout roll.
Okay. I was hoping for Pathfinder, but sure.
I know.
So, let's see. Scout is health, and I don't have it. So, we're having my health. Is that correct?
Yeah.
So, my health is 2. Sounds like Tomer is, you know, well.
Tomer's giving you a helping die.
So, that's 3, then halved, which we round up, I think. So, I get 2. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. 2 dice.
Unfortunately, the only way I can help you is to, like, walk far away from you so that I don't accidentally, like, bump into you, because Oren is not exactly the stealthiest person.
Okay, well, here we go. Here's my scout roll.
Okay, sounds good. What are your traits before you roll?
My traits? Boasting, demanding, and running.
No, those are your nature descriptors. What are your traits?
My traits. Oh, wizard sight and loner.
I thought you were thoughtful. That was a different character.
No.
That would be useful.
Yeah, because I was just saying, like, I'm not giving you Pathfinder, but I'd totally give you thoughtful. Wizard sight and loner. Not feeling either one.
Nope.
Because you have to stay pretty coordinated in this case. Because any one of you tripping him off is just as bad. Alright, so... Do you want to use either of those in your disadvantage? You could use loner to give me 2 dice if you wanted to check.
Well, I rolled these 2 dice before you told me not to, and I have 0 successes right now. So I feel like continuing to mess around with that would be disingenuous.
All right, sounds good.
Do I have an idea what the ob of this was before I embarked on it?
Their nature is 5, and I'm rolling their nature.
Okay. Wow. Yeah, so that's not good.
Their nature of ambushing and devouring. However...
Ambushing is part of their nature.
Yeah. That's why when I was like, oh, wait, should they get their full dice pool for this? Oh, wait, yeah, that's their nature, is ambushing. So, yeah, absolutely, they get their full dice pool on this, because this is what they do. They love playing pranks on people.
Oh, quick note. If you're rolling nature for monsters, and they're doing something that's not within their nature, do they roll half or something?
Yeah, they roll half, round it up. So that's what I was thinking when you were sort of sneaking up on them. Like, oh, maybe they don't get their full nature. Oh no, they totally get their full nature.
So that's how I murdered my team with a slime.
Well, part of it is they're really not supposed to act outside of their nature. Like, mm-hmm. monsters really should just do their nature, but every once in a while they're forced to act outside of it. So,
okay.
You know, like, one of their natures is serving demon lords, which is almost the catch-all for anything they do outside of ambushing or devouring is serving demon lords. But, I mean, let's see what's wrong. Oh, my God.
Oh, what happened?
It's all sixes all the times, guys.
It's all sixes?
No, it's just a lot of sixes.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
It doesn't matter. You guys failed horribly. So
I'll be right back.
I could diddle around and maybe reroll one of these dice, but
no, you're not.
That's not going to make us.
You're not going to be four successes. I mean, I can't reroll my sixes, so rolling a six doesn't actually mean anything. But I got four, so you didn't want that. Okay. Scout. Okay, so we'll wait for John to get back. Okay. So Tomer, you guys are moving slowly, carefully. You're blocking the light, and just as you lift the latch, there's this horrible, rusty, old creak in the door latch that there's nothing you could have done anything about. Like, the latch is on the other side. It's not like you guys weren't being careful. There's just this god-awful screech noise. And it's not that loud, but it reverberates, and you suddenly hear all the sniggering stop in the other room. It goes quiet for a moment. And then, what do you do, actually?
Through the door, people.
Awesome.
Well, the door's open now, right?
Go through the door.
Yeah, you go through the door. As you guys enter, the other door that was, like, you know, ajar, it was already partially open.
Sorry about that.
Flies open, and you guys, and Thaspar, you totally recognize Tuft. He's got his flail, in one hand, and attached to the other end of it, like part of the flail part, is another gnoll who has the flaily bit, like, in his ear, like he was trying to, like, pierce his ear, but with, like, the spiky bit of a flail, and his ear still attached. So he's, like, walking up, he's like, ah, and, you know, and he looks like he's just in agonizing pain as like, they're playing, you know, piercies or earringsies or something like that. And Tuft is just, like, totally, like, not caring that he's putting his buddy in agonizing pain. But of course, when they see you, his eyes go wide, and he howls to his guys to give chase.
Chases.
I'll yell at Tuft, hey, we left you a toy back in the main room, and then, you know, Tomer, slam the door. shut it.
Awesome.
Shut it.
We're going to run.
You're going to run, Z's. Cool. So you've entered the kitchen. You slam the door behind you. They take a moment, obviously, to get going because they – well, no, Tuft doesn't care. He's running along and dragging his buddy behind him, like, but he's not going quite as fast because his buddy is in the middle of getting a piercing. You guys enter the kitchen, or you're in the kitchen. The remains of molding foodstuffs are all over the place. There's a giant, there's a body on the ground with this giant tick on top of it.
I forgot about this guy.
You know, a huge. It's this tick is the size of a chair, and it's and you know it's clearly like firmly planted on this guy. And at the far end of the kitchen are the stairs down. You guys hear the door like shaking and rattling as they're opening it behind you.
Well, we've run down the stairs in fear and panic before.
Yeah, it seems to be your MO of going down these stairs is running in panic and fear.
Yeah.
Sounds good to me. Running into the darkness afraid. We're real good at that.
Yeah.
Is there anything in the kitchen that's standing, like pots or pans or chairs or tables, to knock over as we run past?
Absolutely. Yeah, totally. Okay. There's most of the food here is all, I mean, there's really not food to speak of. It's all, anything that was here is rotted, but there's absolutely all the artifacts of a kitchen that can be tossed over to create a debris.
That's what I'm doing. I'll go last.
Okay.
And just knock things down and behind my paths to try and slow them down.
Sweet.
I'll go in the front to make sure nothing eats Thaspar on our wild descent.
That's kind of you.
I appreciate it.
Cool. Well, then it's Oren, it is you who
runs into the ogre.
Yeah. No, who runs down the path, and something from above you, because there's always something looming above.
Twice in one day.
Yeah. Drops on you.
Oh, is it sick?
Your twist was not actually a null chase. Your twist was getting dropped on by as you run down the stairs the first time, this noxious blob of slime lands on you.
Oh no!
I should say this noxious blob of slime comes falling down at you. It is in the torchlight. You can see it is this putrescent green, and it has been lying in wait for something to run right down the center of these stairs. And it comes at you. It drops down upon you. Let me see what the there's just all sorts of hell for you guys here. Do you like what the gnolls have done with the place?
Oh yeah, they.
You guys, you're gone.
They're like, oh, let's start a slime garden over here, and let's just let's do a flaily contest over here, and let's just leave our pet tick over here.
So the good news was, as you guys ran past it, the tick is quite dead.
Oh, that's okay. Good.
Yeah. It was dissolved by slime.
It you couldn't tell as you first ran in, but when you went past it, it's not moving, and it's the bloated husk is kind of deflated, and clearly, although it took one of the bandits with it, somebody got stabby on it as it was sucking the blood of the bandits. So the tick is nice and dead. But the green slime is not so much. Let me see. There we go. Alien.
I don't know how we fight a green slime.
Carefully.
It's the same way you fight Jell-O, really. You get a spoon and you start eating.
Stupid pencil lead. But the body the tick's on definitely appears to be one of the bandits.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I don't know if you guys remember, but the last time you guys ran down here, that's what happened.
Yeah, I was in with the group last time. And
You weren't with the group last time? That's what's always been with the group.
There was a session where I was not present.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah, so there's just, like, notoriously been, these stairs have been trapped. First by a tick, and now by a green slime.
Yeah, I remember hearing about the tech now that you mentioned it, but I didn't actually... I wasn't around last time. So,
all right.
But it doesn't sound like this guy would have any lore that would interest... Where are my pens?
There is a book of lore in the slime. If you just reach in, you can learn it.
Don't tell me that. Don't think I won't reach in to get some lore. There we are. Nice.
All right. Okay, so... okay, so Oren, this thing is... this thing drops upon you. Oh, sorry, you guys passed turn four. My bad. I'll do it after. You should all mark hungry and thirsty, but I should have said that last time. Oh, no, that was just the test you just did. No, it was not. It was the previous test. So I'm not going to mark it because I'm not going to call it because that's my bad. Scout to pass nulls. All right, Oren, this thing comes flying at you. What are you going to do?
Is it between me and the staircase leading down?
It's as you go down the staircase, it is hanging from above the staircase, and you only at the last moment see it as it's falling down on top of you. It is above you.
I will try to... I think I'm going to try and fling myself... I guess I'm just, as instinctually, I'm probably just going to like try and fall back away from it.
Okay, try to fling yourself back. You're in the front, so if you can push back and no one else, awesome. Okay, I will say that Tomer is still like knocking stuff over up top, but Thaspar, you're close enough that you can see Oren in this. Do you want to aid him? Or you're going to make another health test to try and leap out of this way before this thing lands on top of you.
So, sure. I got two thoughts. One is I could just, you know, grab him and yank him back.
Yep, absolutely.
And then the second thought is I could use my second wizard's aegis and try to shunt the slime off to the side.
You might want to, either one would give him a helping die, but you may want to save the Wizard's Aegis for the modified kill conflict that you'll be in if you don't avoid the slime.
All right, I'll just shank him back then.
just say it. Right, like,
right, I'm just providing a helping die, right.
Totally so, helping either, happy either way, but...
I'll just reach over and grab his collar and, you know, yank him back.
Grab his collar? That's well, Tomer.
Well, no, but I mean, he's got like a cloak or something, right? I mean...
Oh, right. Awesome.
All
right.
Not in a bad dog kind of way. Just in a sure. Come over here.
Cool. So give me help.
Totally
with that.
I have a collar. I never narrated that I have a collar, but
like I can't imagine you not having a collar. It seems so appropriate, Tomer. Yes. What's your raiment, Tomer?
Just my mask is what I used as my.
Right.
I didn't say anything else.
The mask is obviously the defining feature. So if you didn't have anything as your raiment, I would say it totally should be your collar. But the mask is trumps it for sure. The mask is awesome. Okay, so you dive, you leap back, you're getting a helping die, make a health test. It's Ob4.
All right. Thaspar is helping out.
Thaspar is giving you a helping die.
Do I?
If you're not going to make it, use an opportunity to get a check.
There's that.
Well, I have no idea how difficult this challenge will be.
Did he just say?
Oh, did he?
Ob4.
Oh, okay. There's a chance.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go roll as is.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay. Well, I'm going to burn a fate point. To cool. Allow me to reroll my sixes.
Nice.
Take that, GM. Bastard GM. GM bastard.
GM. What's my bastard.
I can't read what your thing says tonight.
It should say fish heads, roly poly fish heads.
Okay. But for me, it's low res.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I can see everyone else's, but not. Oh, no. Soren's is low res now, too.
This yeah, is yours great. Is low res, too.
It's odd. Oh, weird.
Soren's was high res, and then it went low res. It, like, lost resolution after I clicked on it.
I like to flip-flop. So, can I use a persona point to... Did you say we could use a persona point to re-roll failures?
If your wise applies.
Okay. It does not in this case. Only two successes.
Okay, that's terribleness. Okay. So this thing lands on... you and starts burning as soon as it touches you. It starts sizzling and burning your skin, or rather, it's not so much burning as is melting. You know, kind of like lye would, like base, would just sort of eat, like detergent eating away at your flesh.
Warren, do you still have armor failure?
Yep.
Yeah.
Would your armor possibly take that damage?
I do.
Possibly. I thought that might be a thing. Basically, it would burn your armor instead of burning your skin, which is probably good.
Yeah. Well, it your armor certainly can work in this conflict to help you. Orin, you are forced into a kill. Orin, you are forced into a kill conflict.
Oh my gosh.
That's why, because you helped. I'm going to say you're in this conflict as well, but Orin is by default the captain, and kind of in the worst case if you're lost, meaning some of it's on you. You can try and drag Orin out of it, but
wish this game had bloody verses. Anyway,
yeah. So yes, so you're in you're in a special conflict, Orin, called Trapped. It's a modified version of Kill.
Oh, all right. So
it is where you can die, but it essentially cannot. But you can escape it.
Okay.
Escape it.
Yeah, you can try and get out of the ooze before it melts your face off. Tomer, if you want, you can run down now and join the conflict.
I'm going to do that. If I hear my companion howl, I will come to the aid.
Yeah, there's a terrible sizzling, and you see as it begins to melt his flesh, leather and metal. It's an equal opportunity devourer.
Okay. I have a grappling hook. I'm going to try and hook the grappling hook in it and pull it off.
Nice. Let's roll disposition, and that'll be a good action. It sounds like a maneuver action, but
okay.
First, let's roll dispo.
All right.
So, Orin, you're captaining this.
Captain, my captain.
Yeah, you treat it like a kill conflict.
I'm gonna go ahead and apply my brave fate or brave trait. To help me out, since I was bravely venturing forth in this particular case.
Sounds good.
And I must use that bravery to face this beast.
Yeah, this thing is pretty horrible.
Aspar, you're pulling, kind of yanking me out to try and prevent me getting even
wrecked. Yeah, well, does that apply now? I mean, I thought that was that last roll. I mean, I'm in the conflict, right?
Yeah. Yeah. If you have fighter, you can aid on the disposition roll.
I do not have fighter.
Okay. Oh,
I have fighter.
Oh, it's a fighter roll.
It's a fighter roll, but brave certainly applies. I mean, you can certainly use your brave
trait. I'm a fighter, not a lover.
All right. Instinct creep and drop down on unsuspecting prey. It's terrible.
Tomer is starting to think that he had a better deal with his last pack, and just, you know.
This place is a menace.
Yes, it is. What are we doing here?
Well, in honesty to you guys, this was actually the trap on the stairs down that I forgot about the first time you guys went through. So I was like, well, the gnolls have set it up since you guys are gone. But this is actually supposed to be the first time, but. but I missed it. So, cool. So, Oren, go ahead and roll your fighter. Add in a helping die from Tomer. Add in your die from... add in your die from...
Bravery.
All right. Oh, I got 3 successes plus 4 health. That's 7 disposition.
Awesome.
All right. So 2 each and 1 addition to myself.
Okay. Sounds great. Right, I'm scripted for it.
Well, I am personally for killing. My character's mentality is kill it with fire immediately. So awesome. I want to attack.
Very cool. Speaking as the guy with the fire, I'm perfectly willing to kill it with fire.
I want to maneuver with my grappling hook.
All right, so how about we say Tomer, being the quickest of us, probably moves in with your grappling hook to probably, hopefully, drag the thing away, or me away from it. How's that sound?
I'm not hooking you, I'm hooking it, yes.
Oh,
hopefully slime can be hooked.
I apologize, Oren. This conflict uses different skills than a normal kill. It's a kill conflict, but it's uses different skills. So, what did you roll your fighter?
Yes.
What is your nature?
My nature is 4 presently.
What's your fighter?
My fighter is 2.
So you would roll nature instead of fighters. If you roll, 2 more dice, and also Thaspar, if you want to help, because everybody has nature, you can help as well, which you might as well. So that would be 3 more dice. Okay. So, and then I'll tell you guys the skills you use for each action as well. So, so go ahead and roll 3 more, which is good, because you'll want it.
All right, we get 1 more from Thaspar.
Cool. So you're a total of 8. Excellent. So here's your actions. Attack is health. It's basically fending yourself off. Defend is scout. Feint is lore master. And maneuver is health.
Okay.
So you know, it's health, scout.
This isn't on the table, right?
No. It's a special conflict.
Did you make this up?
Nope. You can look on page 153 if you want.
Oh, okay.
It's a creeping ooze.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thaspar, I'll give you that extra health.
I'm using my health for a maneuver.
You're talking about the disposition?
Yes, I'm sorry.
Okay. All right. Cool. Well, it's up to you, although you're probably the one more at risk right now.
Yeah. So, Oren, what actions do you want to take, and who do you want to have take them? Obviously, Tomer's up for a maneuver.
I'm gonna say that Tomer goes first for a maneuver.
Okay.
And that followed by, try and pull a slime off. I'll go second to try and beat the thing off with my own might.
Awesome.
Do I get weapons for this, or is this a special
yes, conflict? Yes, you can use weapons. There's some weird rules about them, which you'll find out as you use them. But yes, you can use weapons. And if you don't, using weapons is good. Mm. Or it can be.
And Thaspar, would you like to attack with fire?
Yeah, that was my thought. I'll just basically hope that this slime can be set on fire with my torch.
Cool. All
right.
I was briefly tempted when he said faint was lore master, but I don't think this thing's going to faint, and then it's bad if I try. Mm.
All right. So starting with the maneuver, From Tomer, do you want to describe your action?
I whip my grappling hook out of my bag and get behind Orin and try and I'm taking my hand and I'm trying to plunge the prongs into the ooze, which I assume has some mass, right? I mean, it's got some, and I'm gonna scrape along backwards and try and get it to come with me onto the floor.
All right. Well, you try to catch hold and a certain amount of just start sort of sliding through it and fraying it, but it obviously has some friction as it begins to tug away at it, as well as beginning to melt from its corrosive oozes. All right. It is, in the meantime, trying to spread itself across you, Orin. It's using its oozing mass to just burble and spread and thin and fully encase you inside of it. It is also maneuvering.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. Oof.
So maneuver versus maneuver, I believe, is independent. Yep. And,
okay. Anybody going to help me?
I will help. I will try to shove myself against the wall to provide Tomer more room to sink his grappling hook in and try and pull it away.
Nice.
Okay, there's one.
Sure. I mean, I'm about to attack with my torch, but I'll. Can I just drop the sack I'm carrying in my other hand and reach out and help pull on the grappling hook rope?
Yeah,
there's not a rope, it's just a hook. I don't have a rope.
You don't have a rope.
You just have a hook?
Because a torchbearer. Who has room for a rope?
Yes, exactly.
Okay,
this is amazing.
Well, I have a rope. I have rope. I didn't know you needed rope.
we'd actually have to apply it. But
all right, so you're just scraping it with a hook.
Yeah,
I tell you what. Well, I'm about to attack it with the torch. Can I actually kind of like try to heat up the prongs as he's, you know?
I think Tomer is holding those prongs.
I'm holding it. I'm holding the.
I don't know that you want to heat up the prongs that he's holding. There's no shaft or anything like that to like for him to get
some sense.
But you can, you know, push the torch at the thing, trying to keep it from spreading. You know,
that would help. Prevent it from spreading, so there's more to.
Sure. I'll do that. I mean, it's not going to be a problem. That's also my action when we get to my action, right?
That's fine.
Yeah, okay. That's fine. All right, I'm gonna roll.
Okay, sounds good.
I'm not tapping nature for a maneuver.
Do you want to use your grappling hook as supplies?
No.
For a die?
I like my grappling hook.
Just saying.
Everything is, all my stuff is precious. I worked long and hard. It took 3 years to earn this grappling hook.
Orin, you don't have anything valuable, do you?
So we can destroy it?
We'll just start going down your inventory list.
Shall I roll?
Yeah, absolutely.
Four successes.
Nice. All right. So.
One of you helped. Four successes.
All right. So the things you can do with four: with one, you can impede it, give it minus one. With two, you can gain position. On it, giving you guys plus two on your next roll. Or with three, you could disarm one of its weapons. And
have weapons to disarm.
it has three weapons to disarm. It has an oozing mass, so you can kind of force it to stay congealed. That's the weapon it's using right now. It also has pseudopods, and it is unflinching.
I want to stop its oozing mass.
Okay. So the you kind of force it to solidify a little bit and shrink back up, and so it doesn't have this. It isn't able to spread out across, Orin. So its oozing mass has been disarmed for this fight.
Do I have anything else left?
You have one left, which you could use to impede it, on its next roll.
Okay, I'm going to impede it.
Cool. All right, it got two, which is going to mean it gains position. Oren, you don't know any place you attack or stab at it, you're likely to be stabbing or attacking yourself. Like, it's got that's just such a thin coating around you that it's really hard. You're, like, scraping at it. You're having a hard time gripping it. And it's, like, eking into your clothes and under your armor. And even as it does it, like, every time it, like, slips across you, you see, like, a little, like, you had a sunburn, and your skin just peeled off after it, and you see raw red flesh beneath it, which is still not quite painful, because thankfully it's having this numbing effect as your skin is chafing off. Once the numbing effect goes away, once the anesthetic ends, well, you'll probably be dead, but, so it has plus two, but minus one, because you just impeded it. And it's lost its oozing mass. All right, Oren, you're up.
All right. I'm gonna take my warhammer and try and scrape it off, and you kind of use the haft of it to like try and pry and scrape whatever I can off of me.
Very good. Very good. Yeah. So as it does, like. The nice thing is your Warhammer is getting an amazingly clean finish. Like, it's clearing all the dirt and the grime and the fingers off of your Warhammer. The fingers being your fingers that are holding it. But you're able to get some grip. And you, like slime, you're, like, pushing it off of you. And luckily it holds itself together just a little bit. In the meantime, you feel your body heating up like Tiger Balm. It is attacking you as well.
Alright. So I'm using health. Plus one for my Warhammer. Anyone want to help me?
Yeah. I mean, you know, I'll as you're clawing up underneath it, I'll try to like maneuver the torch underneath drive it away from your Warhammer further, kind of.
Yeah,
thing.
It's not keen, particularly on the torch. It sizzles and sparks, and
so he's made a little tent, and then I'm trying to widen the tent out, right? You know, he's got his Warhammer here, and I'm edging underneath it with the torch.
Awesome.
Did you learn this from your time playing Burnsies?
I'm the flame bringer, damn it.
It's gonna bring some flames already, motherfucker.
I sort of learned this from my impromptu fungus curing proper procedures.
All right.
I have the dagger of red hotness ready to go if you need it.
The dagger of healing. Tommy helping out, or
oh, yeah.
Tommy, you want to help attack this thing, shove it off?
Yes, I got it to congeal, and my hook is in it, and so I'm gonna help yank.
All nice. Right,
take a die. Help with health. Oh, do you want to use your Warhammer supplies for this?
Ha!
No.
Okay.
Would that just give me another die?
Yeah.
Beyond the normal weapon die?
Yeah.
No. Alright, I have six successes.
Six successes? Holy moly, that's awesome. Alright, it has three successes. So,
what were your two actions?
Oh, wait. Shoot. I forgot the minus die.
Should Why I just were you take... minus a die?
Wasn't I impeded?
No, it was impeded.
I thought it impeded.
It tried to gain position, but it was more impeded by.
Yeah,
Tomer,
it gained position, so it got plus two dice, but minus one because of the impede.
Okay.
So your die pool was not affected at all by its maneuver last time.
Okay.
So you're down. Okay, awesome. So you managed to scrape like a significant amount of it. And at some point, you actually find like where the membrane is thicker, and you just mash it with your Warhammer against the wall, and it kind of starts dissipating and losing cohesion. as it's like slipping and trying to hold on to you. As it peels off of you, like not completely off, but as it starts to slide off of you, you look in horror as you see just a huge slough of your skin come off. And this time it's not red. This time the greenish mass becomes a Christmas tree, a Christmas melody of red and green as your blood just sort of pours into it. Actually, you have leather armor, right?
Yes.
It does not say it ignores
slimy goodness.
It doesn't say it ignores armor, so go ahead and roll your armor and see if it helps.
So I have to roll high in order for it to be effective.
Did you both attack?
Yes. Success. Yes.
All right, cool. So you only lose 2 points of disposition.
As opposed to what?
3.
Oh. Would have knocked me out.
Which would have knocked him out. Yeah.
All right. It is Thaspar's turn.
Help.
All right, Thaspar.
So, it's sort of... It's been pushed away from the Warhammer a little bit. It's been pushed into the... It's being held by the grappling hook to another degree.
Yeah.
And I am just going to try to actually set it on fire, preferably at the part where it's furthest from Orin's actual body.
Sounds good.
As long as it seems like it's actually going to catch on flames, then yes, I'm going to use my torch as a supplies.
Awesome. Cool.
I mean, I'm happy to lose the torch. I'm less happy to lose the light. But if it's gonna burn, then I will totally set it on fire.
All right. Go ahead and use that.
So that's a health roll. We said
it's a health roll, and you get a helping die. It is unflinching. It can't actually use that weapon because it's already chosen a weapon this turn, but I'm just going to describe it as is persistent in as it gets on you, as you get your torch into it, it gets on you, it stings and you flinch back, and it tries to fend you off. It is defending.
Oh.
So yes, you should have fainted because you would have fucked it up, but well... Better than it fainting and you defending, I suppose.
I will help by trying to push as much of the mass as I can towards Thaspar's torch for him to burn.
Excellent. Tomer, you got anything for me?
No.
Okay.
No, you can't help in the attack?
No.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Hold on, wait a second. Tomer not helping his master? I'm so confused.
I'm not feeling very well right now.
What'd you say?
I'm not feeling very well right now.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear. Is it because there's a green slime eating your face?
No. Just don't want to get a headache.
Yeah, all right, well, let's go with this, and we'll see where we're at. All right, so that's 2 successes.
Okay.
One of which is a 6. Is this slime native to the moat house?
No, it has been set here. This is a trap that's been set up.
I see.
I believe
attacking your nature.
Yeah. So I can.
Let me double check that. I believe, if I'm reading it, that this was specifically set up as a trap.
I can spend a fate point to reroll 6s, and I don't need to use the wise for that, right?
Correct.
The wise would be to roll a failed die. I see.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, if it's native to the moat house such that I could, have a deeper understanding.
Yeah, they've been carefully placed here and fed in position over the central arch. So, yeah. Right.
So I'm going to spend a fate point to reroll my lone 6.
Okay.
So I've got 2 successes so far.
Keep rolling on.
And that's a 3rd one.
Awesome. Cool. You tie. So it had 3 as well, so it does not gain any dispo, but it does not lose any. And it is now a conflagration of Slimy Flame.
So, or I could get 2 checks by letting him win the tie, right? Or do I need to use a trait in that somehow?
Yeah, you would have to use a trait in that. You could, your wizard sight could overwhelm you and make you flinch back, and it would gain a point of disposition, but you would move the tie in his favor.
Which would mean I would take some damage, right?
No, just it would, because it was defending. It would just, it would gain dispo.
Oh, I see.
Which it can do, because it just lost a bunch from Orin's action.
Right. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead, and because of my loner trait, I'm going to kind of flinch back and not play along with the help there that Orin's... I'm once I start getting burned, I revert to type and flinch back a little bit, such that... He breaks the tie in his favor.
Do you mention that it stings as like bits of Orin are like sloughing off?
Right.
That stings my hand. Ow. Nice. Okay. Cool. So its disposition goes up to 7, and it does not have any armor. No, it wouldn't matter. This is defendable. Okay. Cool. Next position, and we should probably go fast because it looks like we're losing John.
Yeah.
Sorry, man.
Does that count as a fail on a health roll, by the way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep, because you broke it in its favor. So right. Tipped it over. Okay. All right, let me script.
But it is a little bit on fire, yes.
It is a little bit on fire, yeah. Well, I mean, technically it won the conflict there. It healed. I would say it has your torch in it.
Okay.
You were using it as supplies, so...
Right.
Yeah, so your torch is, like, bobbling around, still on fire inside of it.
It's a torch cigar.
I'm fine with that. Like I said, as long as there's fire, I don't really care that I control it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's the torch itself is being eaten away, like, rapid action rotting, but the flame is still... flame is still going. The ooze does not stop, and in fact, it bubbles and hisses and pops along the edge.
Okay.
All right. I have scripted. Have I scripted? No, I didn't. I thought I scripted. Or, yes, I did script. Sorry.
Shall I propose defend, maneuver, attack? Defend to get back a little bit of dispo, maneuver to set up for the attack. And
okay.
Tomer, would you be interested in doing the scouting?
Yeah, I can do the scouting. Which is defend.
Mm-hmm.
Okie dokie.
And the maneuver was what, health as well?
Mm-hmm. Maneuver is health, yeah. Maneuver and attack are both health.
Taspardi, would you like to do the maneuver?
I'm basically going to suck at both of them, but sure.
I'll do the attack since I have okay amount of attack. All right.
Awesome. Okay.
What order are we doing those in? I'm sorry.
Defend, maneuver, attack.
Okay.
So, Tomer, what are you going to do to try and aid your ally and get this thing off and help him fight this thing off?
Oh, because I am first.
You're defending, yeah. So I believe the way that this is intended with defend working at scout
yeah,
is it's not like yanking it off. It's more like telling him, like, look, it's getting there, or, you know, watch out, or, you know, kind of giving him advice to pull it off of him rather than actually yanking and prodding.
I'm going to advise him how to scrape it, point out that there's things along the wall that he can scrape. Oh, I don't hear you. What happened? You were making talking sounds, Sean.
Oh, yeah, I can't hear him either.
Yeah, it's true.
Oh.
There's just a strange expression on Sean's face. He looks like he's in shock.
I am in shock. Awesome. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
My mic decided to cut out because it's fun like that because it's awesome. All right, so I was saying the defend action is akin to telling, you know, get it off you and telling Oren how to protect himself.
Right, like telling him how to scrape it off the, like use the stuff in the environment to try and scrape it off him.
Sounds good. Excellent. And it is attacking. With pseudopod shoots out, and as you get close to it, Tomer, a pseudopod bolts out, shoots out of it, and wraps around your ankle, or tries to wrap around your ankle, rather.
Right. So this miss is attacking me.
Yeah, because you're the person who's up.
Okay. Okay, so that's my scout. I have 3 dice and scout. Is anybody helping me do this?
I cannot.
Surely Oren can help me by following my directions.
He's panicking too much. He's of no use.
Yeah, and I will help by as you're giving Oren directions. I will push Oren in that direction as well.
Okay. So is Oren literally panicking too much to help?
Well, I don't really have a skill to offer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I'm a scout. So.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Oh, do I have to be off helping with scout? Then
yes.
Yeah, then I'm out. Never mind.
Oh man.
Oof.
Well, okay. Can I beginner's luck that? I don't think I can I?
Not when if you were the one rolling it, yes. But
right. Another, yeah. If I have to help with scout, I can't help. I don't have.
Or what's your wise?
Twilight wise.
Yeah.
No.
Not feeling it.
Worst wise ever.
Yeah.
I want to. Terrible. I want to tap my nature.
That's a good idea.
My nature is 4.
Okay.
This isn't boasting, demanding, or running.
Okay.
So that's going against it, right?
Yeah, but that's okay.
Going up against. I think that. So that. So I, that's that a persona?
That's a persona. Yes.
Okay. This is not a wolf. 4 and 9. Okay.
No, it's not.
All right. I want to see how I do.
You do, however, notice that you're like down. You're down the stairs, right? You do, however, notice that like the door has been kicked in, and the gnolls are above you, watching you and sniggering at you guys.
Oh, of course.
Like they're just like, this is hilarious. They think this is the best thing ever. Like they're not getting involved. They're not messing with you. They're just laughing. Anyway, so Tomer would notice.
Can I use my foolhardy?
Yes, you can. Just describe how you bring it in. I can see a couple ways. Are you going to grab the pseudopod and try and yank on it?
I'm going to let it... If I let it, like, try and latch wrong my ankle, so I'm pulling it with me.
Yeah, awesome.
So, okay, I'm going to use... I can use it one die per roll, so...
Oh, is foolhardy a level 2 trait?
Yes.
Awesome. Be foolhardy all the time.
Have you rolled?
I have. I have 4 successes.
Wait, how many dice should have I had? I should have had 3 plus 4. That's 1. I have 4 successes.
Awesome. Is that a tie?
Yeah, it's a tie. I do not want to break it in your favor because you'd do 4. You'd do 4 damage if I did, or
no,
you would.
I just do 1.
Oh, you do 1.
Because it would just give me. I mean, it doesn't invalidate your roll.
But the, would that then tax my nature if I?
Yeah. Well, your nature is going to be taxed by 1 anyway, no matter what.
Oh, then I can break it in your favor.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Whenever you use your nature against itself, it gets taxed by 1. So, and failing. By 1, taxes it by 1, so.
Okay. So it's, so if I break it in your favor, it's taxed by 1. Mm-hmm. And?
And you take a point of disposition as the thing starts.
Okay, I'll take
sizzling
it.
Away your flesh on your leg.
But it gives me checks. All right.
Awesome.
Did it again. All right. That was a valiant attempt.
Yeah, it was. And you, let's see, it did not, you guys lost this, but you guys lose a point of disposition. But yeah, it did not eat you, or Oren for that matter. Speaking of Oren, are you up right now?
No.
I thought I was. I'm maneuvering, Taspar's right?
Up. Cool. What are you doing, Taspar?
I'm maneuvering, right? Is that right?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Here is my plan. This thing is kind of an oozy, slimy kind of deal. And I've got all sorts of alchemical powders and whatnot. And I am going to also use my wizard sight and attempt to figure out something that I can like sprinkle on it, like salt on a slug kind of thing, to make it pull away from Oren.
That's brilliant.
So
that seems like an awesome thing to do. You can't really use up your alchemical supplies. They're sort of implied to always have them. So.
Right. But
I'm gonna give you a weapon die for that. It's totally brilliant. Yeah.
And I'm using my wizard sight to kind of figure out the right sort of combination.
Oh yeah. So yeah, when you look at this thing through wizard sight, you can see that it is a in fact some kind of.
It seems kind of acidy, so I'm probably gonna sprinkle it with some base or something, kind of harden it up and.
Yeah, it
cut down on its mobility.
Yeah, it is definitely a the offspring of some horrific experiment that mad sorcerers have done in the past. You can see in it, you can see like all the like little, just the little like bumpy bits and the darker patches of it. You now clearly see as like the faces of people that it has absorbed.
Right.
With your wizard sight.
Okay, so it's two die because it's health, one die for the wizard sight, one die for the weapon thing. Anybody help me?
Yeah. This is health, so anybody can help.
And you're maneuvering?
I am maneuvering.
Well, it's attached to my legs.
And I'll kind of in unison kind of help.
I'm going to try and kick it. I'm try and maneuver it so that you can. Get a good
stretch it out so I have a nice exposed surface to sprinkle powders into.
Exactly.
Yep. I'll do much the same.
Excellent. You guys will play. Well, it's the wishbone and your tug of warring.
Yeah, exactly.
I love it.
Well, it lets go of. It tries to pull away from. Tomer. So literally is a tug of war and. Slip itself underneath Oren's armor and like escape from the chemicals that you're applying to it, and like carrying the torch is like bobbling along with it all the time.
Right.
It's defending.
Okay. So here we go. I like it so far. I have 4 successes.
I have 4 as well.
Oh my god.
If
you just keep getting 4, this is never gonna end.
I've rolled 4 successes on it's 6 dice like every single time. I know it's evil. I'll switch dice. It doesn't
so that's
matter.
Another bump. That's another bump.
So when it says
there's no, yeah, no, you got margin 0 and it got margin 0. So
that's just a no op basically.
Yep.
And if I tried to spin Persona, most of that stuff I had to do before the roll, right?
Yeah, you'd have to use your Wise.
Yeah, my Wise doesn't apply. We already established that. Okay. So I think that's what happens then.
Okay. Well, nothing bad happened. All right. Oren, you're up next.
I'm attacking?
Yeah. After, like, the alchemical bits that that Thaspar went on it, got on it, and like maybe because the torch has been burning on it so long that like it finally has broken its cohesion, the whole thing just like splashes like a like it like splashes and like goes inert on the floor in front of you like you've defeated it. And then just like as it thinks you've like turned your attention away or you've like stopped it, like jets up at you, but you're totally ready for it. You bring your hammer down, or whatever you're going to do. You're totally prepared. It's fainting.
It is. It's hammer time.
It's hammer time.
I'm pretty much just going to try and bring my hammer down onto it.
Cool. Do you want to use your hammer as supplies?
No.
Tap your nature.
I'm going to use my persona point to tap my nature.
Okay. Cool.
And
it fainted?
Yeah. It was a terrible move, apparently.
Okay.
Figured you guys might defend.
Does anyone want to help?
What do you? You're doing a health, so
yes.
Well, I'll just it doesn't like this. I'll keep on sprinkling my alchemical stuff and try to drive it towards the hammer. I'll solidify it more so that it's more of a shattery blow, less of a splashy blow.
And is there anything improvise? Like I want to like grab a bowl or a pot or something.
Sure. Yeah. From the kitchen. Absolutely.
And try and. So what are you trying to do, Oren? How are you attack with your hammer?
Yeah. I'm
going to provide the anvil for you to smash it against. That's what I'm going to do. Nice. Smash it against this.
Nice. Scoop it up with like a pan or something like that.
Yes.
Give them some substance to smash.
Yes.
Right. Nice. Oh my gosh.
Silica gel. I'm sprinkling it with silica gel to dry it out.
Yeah. Harden it. Get it congealed enough that a hammer blow will actually hurt it rather than just splatter it.
Alright. That is a total of 6 successes.
Oh my god! Alright, do you have any sixes?
I do.
Alright, It is currently at 1 disposition. Oh. That's 7 left, so if you can get one more...
I'm gonna fate dice this.
Splattered.
I don't know why you guys let it break that tie in its favor last round.
You did that! I'm only...
Clearly that's responsibility of the conflict captain.
Yep.
My mistake.
I got 2 checks, though. It seemed like it was worth a point of disposition.
Oh, yes.
I still got to fix that damn blanket.
I did get 1 more success.
Huzzah! Okay.
For a total of 7.
This is
going to be a little compromisy, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
We have a slime pancake now.
Yep. It hardens with the application of Dasper's solvents and undulants. And as Tomer scoops it up, you bring the hammer down, and it actually hardens like oobleck into like a paste for a moment, and you crack that paste, and you shatter it, and send bits of it scattered about. Normally with trapped conflicts, you can't actually kill it, but I think you've killed it. I think this was a kill conflict because it could kill you. So I'm reversing that around to say that you've done more than just escape it. You shattered this thing, and like it breaks up into tiny little bits of ooze that kind of just seep into the ground, listlessly. Oof. And from it, your torch, that is the torch that was that Dasper used, dies out as it's gone. But like you could see the wood is just like totally rotted away from the time that's been in there. Mm-hmm. Orin, you're bleeding horrifically, and from your chest and your arm, and now you, as like fresh air, like now that's not covered by, slime, as air gets across it, it suddenly stings, and you feel incredible pain. Tummer, the same way. Your leg, you look down and there's just a whole area of where it wrapped around your leg where your pants are completely burned through, and it's actually burned into the muscle of your leg. So you guys both have injuries.
That's bad.
But it is dead. It leaves behind things too. Let's see what it leaves behind. Let's see what crud was in it that did not get devoured. That is hopefully not a bent nail. Because you guys hella just killed this thing. Oh my god. So close. All right, apparently what it cannot dissolve, the substance that it could not dissolve, was silver.
Ooh.
So it leaves a pile of, it's kind of a boring thing for it to have been inside.
Yeah.
It. But, yeah. Would you prefer something else? Actually, Conflict Captain, you tell me. You have a choice between would you like to leave? Would you like it to have left behind coin, loot, or knowledge?
Loot's more exciting.
All right. Okay. Then coins it is. You have one die of cash of silver that is as it disintegrates and kind of drifts away like. Oozes. You can see sparkling clean, the cleanest coins you've ever seen. These look like they're freshly minted. There's not a bit of dust or anything like that on them.
That's one slot worth of treasure?
Yeah, it's one die.
Okay.
I rolled an 11 on the loot table, which is valuables, and a 12 was magic.
So I
was sad that you guys were one away. I don't think there's any way to bump those tables up either. No, there is not. No.
I guess I have some pack space. I will grab the silver.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait, hold on. Hold on, might 4, roll once for every creature defeated, plus 1 or minus 1 on loot table, player's choice after the roll. Hold on a second. I rolled an 11, so you could bump that down to stuff, if you'd like. Stuff includes...
plus 1
or
minus 1?
Things like bags of rocks, string, and dried leaves. You can leave that as treasure and valuables, where it'll stay as cash, or you could bump it up to magic.
Magic.
I just... Magic. It's a player's choice.
Magic. I'm all for magic.
Magic. All right.
Magic.
You know, the reason why it's up in that on the ceiling is because it's actually a piñata for the gnolls, and they're trying to beat it open to get the magic item out.
All right, sounds good. So above it, what it had been clutching to, propped in the stone.
This game is all about the fat loot, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not.
Yeah. is a stone rod that looks to be somehow crafted so that the end of it is wrapped in knots, like it's like stone knots that are that you know that there's that seem impossibly woven and intricate for being made of stone. And that's like what it was hanging off of. clearly something set in the ceiling above, but removable.
I would like to study that. I'm going to claim it's lore.
Claim it's lore. It totally is lore. All right.
I would like to study it for free.
You can study it for free. Let me see what the difficulty of studying. Let me look at Lore Master real quick here. Anyway, so you're going to study it, but I would just want to point out that like there's like three gnolls standing there flat, like, and they are amazingly amused right now.
So did they bring any light with them?
Yeah. Okay. They've got a torch. So you're in dim light right now.
We should probably grab the thing and then probably...
Actually, you're not even in dim light. They're in dim light. You're in icy light over there. Because the torch only provides light for one, two, and dim light for two, and there's four of them, so they're using up all their light. But, you know, but you can still see a little bit. It's not like you're...
There's enough light to grab the stone thing and then book it.
Yes, you can grab the stone thing and then book it. Because they don't seem to be making chase anymore. They were just hoping you would get eaten by the green slime.
Stone thing in one hand, pick up my small sack that I dropped with the other hand, and then down the stairs, yeah?
Good
for everybody?
I totally say the small sack was gone, but everyone else already took injuries, so yeah, small sack's still there. Tomer, you're walking with a limp.
Okay.
And everything hurts for both of you guys. That thing was gnarly.
Yep.
Sorry, I ate your faces.
But, quite all right.
But you guys get down the stairs. I'm looking for the... there we go. Skill factors for Lore Master.
Well, we can... Because John wants to go, we can also do that. Are we camping? Or do we want to camp? Or?
I think we just need to probably end the session at this point.
Yes, please.
John, yeah. You're dying.
I'm having a tough night.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, sir.
So let's put off the lore roll to next week, but our next time. But I don't know if we'll, and then we'll worry about whether we're in camp or whatever. Sound good?
That sounds good. That sounds excellent. All right, let's do. John, are you up for doing rewards persona?
Quickly.
Okay.
Quickly.
All right, let's do yours first, and we'll let you go. What's your belief?
That I'm gonna be a good dog, and look after Thaspar's best interests. I was not a good dog tonight.
Okay. What's your goal?
Find a new member for the pack to make it stronger.
Do you consider gnolls potential members?
Not this big pack of gnolls.
Okay. What's your instinct?
Always cook before we make camp.
Okay. None of those came up.
Nope.
All right. Let's see. MVP... Oren?
I vote Oren.
I got us into all sorts of trouble.
Yeah.
You did. You were the one who did all the damage to the slime, though. I think you did 6 on one and 7 on another. It had 13 disposition. I think, Oren, you did all of the...
It's Oren.
Yeah, go for it.
All right. Team worker? Person who was there for everybody cannot be Oren.
Who was there?
Who helped the most, who used the most of their supplies, who was
Thaspar did use up 2 of his torches to the monsters.
He used up 2 of his torches, and torches are pretty flimsy in the way of supplies, but I think that's as close as he gets.
Yep.
And did help in virtually every role.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. And embodiment? Who played their character?
I don't think this was an embodiment night.
I don't think it was either.
No, not particularly. Right.
I think it was getting back used to this game night.
Yes.
Remembering how the hell it works. Me being, why did I put so many goddamn monsters? Well, it's not even me. It's fucking why there's so many goddamn monsters in this dungeon.
I'm going to take off, okay?
All right. That's fine.
Take care.
I'm fading. It's good to see you, Sean. Let's talk about Blades in the Dark sometime.
Yes, I'd love to.
Have a good night. Good to see everyone.
Yep. Good to see you, too. Sorry, not feeling well.
Yep.
Get better.
I feel better soon. All right. Yikes. Okay. So let's do your guys' goal, belief sensing some goals, and then we'll be done. Let's see. Oren, your belief?
My friend's health is more important than my own.
Sort of accident. Yeah, yeah.
He was in front, specifically
said,
to protect me.
I'll go first to protect Aspar, and that is exactly why you got a green slime on your face. Like, that was written right into the dungeon. It was like the first person who goes down without looking up gets green slime on the face. So, yeah, take a fate for that.
All right.
Thaspar, what's your goal?
I need to hold the group together. Oh, wait, belief or goal?
Belief, sorry.
Yeah, sorry. I need to hold the group together. It's the belief.
I don't think that was tested. I mean, yeah. I think it's prevalent. It's possible.
It didn't come up very much. Yeah, I'll buy that.
Yeah, it's possible that in all that chaos with running from the spider and then running from Knowles and all that, that you could have, but I don't even know what you would have done. So yeah, that's. What's your goal thus far?
We will honor Sixto's parents' wishes.
You're getting closer. Go ahead and take a fate. And Oren, take a fate, because I know yours is very similar.
Yep.
Your instinct, Daspar?
If we find lore, study it.
Oh, you're so close.
Yeah, but I mean, I'll get it in the next session.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's fine. All right. And Oren, yours?
I always check for the presence of undead. No go on this time.
Did not come up. But, you know, the good news was there's no undead.
Yeah.
There's just necrotic green slime.
They're just living things that want to eat us.
Yeah. Okay, excellent. Thank you, guys.
Well, thank you.
Should we be hungry and thirsty?
Yeah, you should be hungry and thirsty.
Oh, I'll mark that real quick. No, not fresh. I'm not fresh.
Yeah, so currently, Oren, you're injured and hungry and thirsty.
Ugh.
Yeah, top and the bottom of those things. But an injury was not a bad way to get out of that.
I was totally expecting to walk away dead.
Oh yeah, yeah. If your leather armor hadn't have saved you, you would have been either dead or would have given you injured and sick and had your a lot of your gear destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
But it only got a minor concession at the end, so it was really the difference between 1 point of dispo as to whether or not you guys. Oh, no.
Okay, all right, next time I won't break the tie.
Oh, God, yeah. It was, I think it was a monster. It was a beast. So.
I feel it would have been the ultimate irony to be eaten by a slime this session, because I killed my players last time I ran Torchbearer with a slime.
Oh, nice. Yes, that would have been pretty ironic. And as you know, you would have turned into a slime.
Oh.
So it would have been Oren the slime.
Oh.
As the final result. Now you guys eked by. Well played, gentlemen. Sorry if it was a little rocky on my part. I realized I hadn't run this in a while, which I thought I remembered everything. And
it's fine.
No worries.
All right, I'll talk to you guys soon. We'll doodle another for another session.
Sounds good. Thank you again, Sean.
Thank you.
Thanks for running.
Later, guys. See you.